Metrics are like the backbone of a manufacturing operation. They hold it all up. Making good use of these metrics and moving adeptly toward continuous improvement requires muscles, tissue, and tendons. These are optimization techniques or methodologies. Optimization is so important and complex that several distinct methodologies have emerged. These are like different schools of thought. Some of the most famous optimization schools are theory of constraints, or TOC, total quality management, or TQM, quick response manufacturing, or QRM, lean, and Six Sigma. Each school approaches optimization from a different focal point. For example, theory of constraints focuses on limitations or constraints, like bottlenecks. Find a constraint and fix it. Then find the next constraint and fix that, and so on. Total quality management focuses on quality improvements. Drive quality through direct employee involvement and customer centricity. Quick response manufacturing focuses on speed. Make it a race. Keep track of all steps and outpace the competition, both internal and external. But no school is as famous or common as Lean or Six Sigma, which share many underlying principles. Lean focuses primarily on reducing waste in a workflow. Waste is broadly defined. Time, effort, materials, these can all be waste. Six Sigma focuses primarily on reducing defects and variation. Lean and Six Sigma are two separate stars here and have successful solo careers in their own right. However, they also form a famous double act. The two schools are often combined via an approach known as Lean Six Sigma, which aims to reduce both waste and defects. Lean Six Sigma has become so influential that its founders created an international certification framework, culminating in the well-known Black Belt certification to standardize its implementation. Mastery of any of these schools can take years. And any given manufacturing organization may apply one or multiple schools to its in-house approach. Rather than dive into the details of these approaches, let's consider how a company might apply them. Say that a manufacturing engineer notices that overall labor effectiveness, a function of availability, performance, and quality, is declining. Naturally, they want to fix things. One of the ways a company can apply an optimization methodology is to help diagnose the problem. Each school will take a unique approach here. Let's consider Lean. Lean emphasizes reducing waste, and the first step in reducing it is spotting it. Lean has a framework for this, the seven wastes: overproduction, waiting, transportation, inappropriate processing, excess inventory, unnecessary motion, and defects. To spot wastes, Lean encourages direct observations via daily walks through the factory floor. These are called Jemba walks. In our example, company plant managers will be looking for wastes that might be contributing to the drop in OLE. For example, if employees are idling before a shift due to delayed safety checks, that would be a waiting waste, leading to an availability concern. If employees have to take a few steps to gather tools, that would be an unnecessary motion waste, leading to a performance concern. Waste in the form of defects would, of course, be a quality concern. Getting to the root causes can require multiple layers of observation. For example, the cause of the unnecessary motion waste could be an excess of inventory cluttering the floor. The root problem, in this case, would be traced back to over-ordering. Methodologies like Lean will emphasize other strategies as well. Here are a few more common Lean strategies which are used in other methodologies as well. One is Poka-Yoke techniques, Japanese for mistake-proofing. The idea is to make mistakes obvious, or ideally impossible. This will help reduce defect waste. Ever tried to remove the car key before you've put it in park? You can thank the car maker for this preventative Poka-Yoke fixture. For a manufacturing example, consider a circuit board assembly. Many parts are polarized, positively charged on one side, negatively on the other, and must be oriented in a certain way. Ever put the batteries in upside down? A Poka-Yoke approach would be to shape the parts so that they can only fit in the correct direction. Another Lean strategy is the Andon system. The idea here is to use real-time status indicators at every step of a manufacturing process. Red, yellow, green. Real-time status tracking can help manufacturers respond quickly to issues and avoid compounding wastes. Another strategy emphasized in Lean is just-in-time manufacturing, or JIT. JIT is a core pillar of Toyota's system. Its goal is to reduce inventory waste by waiting to produce items until the moment they're needed. In terms of key metrics, JIT means matching the cycle time, actual production time per unit, with the takt time, the production time per unit needed to keep up with but not exceed demand. JIT usually relies on close coordination with suppliers, since raw materials delivery needs to be well-timed with the manufacturing itself. While JIT, Andon, and Poka-Yoke are all strategies that originated with Toyota as part of TPS, they have become mainstays across industries.